guys, literally, we're running away from rockets over here. Unbelievable. Oh, shit. 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 I was just coming to show you what happened half an hour ago. It hit our land over here. And they're coming more. Look at this. Oh shit, I gotta get out of here. I gotta go to a shelter. Fucking scary. This is life in Israel. No shelter. Imagine kids going through this. I can't believe it. Oh my God. We gotta get out of these hills. They're coming more. Are you watching this? I cannot believe a country.
Shalom, friends. As you have probably seen on the news, Israel is at war again, and we need your prayers now more than ever. Sirens were heard throughout Israel, including Jerusalem and Tel Aviv. We haven't had rockets reach that far since 2014. Our staff resides in those areas, and we spent our evening with our families in bomb shelters as the explosions rang overhead. In total, over 1,000 missiles were fired in the last 24 hours. Thankfully, the Iron Dome was able to intercept the majority, but several rockets made it through our defenses and made direct hits on buildings, buses, and cars, injuring many and killing five last night alone. Not only are we facing rocket barrages from the south, but all across the country, there are riots of Muslims in the streets. The riots last night in Lod, just south of Tel Aviv, have been referred to as Kristallnacht and civil war, as synagogues, cars, and businesses were burned and Muslim mobs roamed the streets with Molotov cocktails and rocks. Israel's police minister called the situation unprecedented. On the final days of Ramadan, Hamas used the failed Palestinian election and property disputes in East Jerusalem to spur rocket fire and riots that led to the conflict we're in. But as the news reporters seek to unwrap the causes and solutions to this conflict, we know that the core of this hatred and war is much deeper than the current events today. This hatred and animosity centers around a spiritual conflict as old as time, and the only true lasting peace can come through the Prince of Peace, Yeshua, our Messiah. We know that God's desire is to turn the hearts from hatred to love through our Messiah, Yeshua. This current conflict has hit very close to home, as one of our faculty members, who lives in Ashkelon, just south of Tel Aviv, suffered a direct hit of a rocket into his building. The rocket hit two floors below, killing his neighbor and seriously injuring several people in his complex. His apartment is destroyed, glass is everywhere, and his building compromised. But as we reached out to him and his family to provide assistance and a place to stay, he insisted to remain with his neighbors in this time of trouble. Here's his own words. The worst thing is that people do not know God. Now is a good opportunity for me to remind my neighbors that He is. His peaceful and passionate heart for the gospel is an inspiration for us all. We remain standing together in prayer, both our Jewish and Arab staff members and students, and we invite you to join us in prayer for our people, both Arab and Jews, that God would reach those full of fear and hatred. Would you pray with me? Father, we pray to you for your peace, the peace that comes from above over the land of Israel and the surrounding area. Father, we pray that you will rule in our hearts and particularly for people that are full of fear and hatred now. We pray that your peace will come. We pray that more people will seek the Prince of Peace, the Messiah Yeshua himself, at this time. It is in his name that we pray. Amen. Thank you for standing with us in prayer, and thank you for being one for Israel.